It's Dagan here from PMTVUK. Welcome back to the channel and this week's PMT behind the scenes vlog, where myself, my lovely iPhone, and the even more lovely Shure MV88 Plus stereo condenser microphone, which is perched on top of my phone right now, take you on a tour behind the scenes with PMT, unbox some really cool things and show you all the fancy new goodies we've had land this week, give you some tone tips, and mostly just have a bit of fun, really. This week's going to be no different, so strap yourselves in. Firstly, I'm going to be talking about the amazing and new Affinity guitars from Squier. Absolutely crackers. The fit and finish is just mint. Now, I want to talk about these because I've seen pictures online and specs spoke about, but there's been no videos on these guitars, and there is a full in-depth, properly mic'd up video coming very soon at PMTVUK, so be sure to get yourselves subscribed, but I want to give you guys a little preview on my favourite one, which is this one, which you'll hear very, very shortly. As well as show you a smattering of the other beautiful new Affinity Squiers that Fender have kindly sent me. These are pre-production ones as well, so if you want to pre-order any of the guitars that you're going to have a little sneak preview of, click the links in the description box down below. Like this Jaguar bass. It's an Affinity Jaguar bass with a humbucker in. This isn't a lot of money, but there's a lot of bass here. Well, there's a lot of quality behind me right now, Fender. Mint. And then, as always, I'll take you on a little shop tour, see if anything tasty's landed, any lovely new colours, any beautiful new guitars.
What colour's that in the vent there? Tim.
We'll find out together in 2 minutes or so. I know GMAC wants to show you some new cool synth stuff, so all the techie folk out there, that's for you.
GMAC, my man, how's it going? That sounds good. What's this guy?
This is the Roland JU-06.
And then we're going to end with what you've probably seen in the title of this video and the thumbnail. I'm going to teach you guys how to play one of my favourite Eddie Van Halen licks. Eddie Van Halen is a huge inspiration of mine, and I play this lick quite a lot. And it sounds super intense. It's from Spanish Fly. It sounds like it's really hard to do, but it's actually not that hard to do. And it sounds kick-ass. But anyways, let's start with a fun little vlog product review demo. Like I said before, I've seen lots of pictures of these guitars online, a lot of specs thrown around here and there. These are the new Affinity guitars from Squier. Now, that's the budget starter guitar from Squier. And I can't believe they brought something like this out. I'm doing this one, and like I said, there's going to be a full review of all the new guitars at PMTVUK, so click subscribe down below for that. But for now, this is my favourite. A Stratocaster, two humbuckers, it's a poplar body, full 25.5-inch scale, it's got a satin maple neck, but a gloss big 70s CBS headstock, a 9.5-inch radius Pow Ferro Indian Laurel fingerboard. And yeah, those two humbuckers. One volume, one tone, and a three-way switch. And it's a two-point trim. So it's like what you get on the fancy American things. And this will be 200 quid? 150? £250? It's absolute insanity. Insanity. Beginners out there don't know how lucky you are. Even if you're not a beginner and you just want a Stratocaster with some humbuckers in to either modify yourself or just have as like a decent quality knock-around guitar which sounds mint out of the box, this is for you. Now I'm aware they've done other humbucker variants of Affinity guitars in the past, but never quite like this. It's absolutely, look, there's you guys. Absolutely crackers. The fit and finish is just mint. The specs that they have is very akin to the big fancy American ones, but they're not a lot of money. And it's a floating trem. So obviously don't hammer it, don't go all Motley Crue, Kickstart My Heart on it, because it might go out of tune, but for the subtler stuff, you can go up as well as down. So this is the chunky bridge pickup. And that lovely creamy neck pickup. good. Very versatile. Turn the tone down, play some jazz. So that's all the preview you're getting. Again, for the 400th time, subscribe to PMTVUK for a full in-depth review of all of these lovely Squier guitars, which you're gonna see now. So like I said before, it's more than just the guitars. There's that lovely Jaguar bass, but there's also this PJ bass, which is in a lovely new kind of dark Lake Placid blue. It has the new Indian Oral fingerboard. Again, it's a satin neck down the back, but it's gloss on the headstock. The PJ configuration, which is one of the most versatile configurations on any bass. Precision bass pickups, jazz bass pickups, you can blend them together because there's an individual volume for each and a master tone control. That's very cool. Moving along, these are just some funky new colours on the Affinity Telecasters, again with that new satin neck and the Indian Laurel fingerboard. This is mint though. This is the HSS Affinity, but as you can see, it's in a glorious new flame maple finish with a burst. So this is the black burst, I think they call it, and there's also Sienna Sunburst, which hopefully you can see on the screen right there. The Jaguar bass with the single humbucker, as well as lots of my manky fingerprints because it's very warm today. This is an awesome thing and it's going to absolutely growl. I can't wait to give it a good bash. Go on, lad. So stay tuned for that. Let's go for a little wander now and see what's tasty in PMT Newcastle this first week of June. Let's have a wander. How's it June already, man? I mean, you can tell by my hair how warm it is, but you know. I'm trying to crack a safe, mate. Ah. Right, let's have a deeks. My favourite place in the world. First off, I've noticed this is where Gold Glory was this morning. Now it's gone, so someone's got a brand new Gold Glory. Amazing guitar. If you haven't seen my video of that, check it out. It was in last week's vlog as well. Some of my favourite Epiphone inspired by Gibson guitars, the Firebird and the Les Paul Junior. The best way to experience some of the most amazing iconic guitars on the planet, but for not a lot of money. They're awesome. Fender-wise, I want to show you some cool colours. Now, what's your thoughts on Fender? Because I love Fender and I love quirky colours, and Fender do quirky colours very, very well, but people like traditional Fenders. But the new American Pro 2s come in teal, and you can get the, where is it? Oh, the Noventa, sorry, that's what I was going to show you. The new Noventa with their P90s.
What colour is that Noventa? Tim.
It's in surf green with that mint green pickguard, but it's quite avant-garde for, Fender. There's also the Telecaster and the Jazzmaster. The Telecaster has one P90 in and the Jazzmaster has three. It's very cool. It's got a string through bridge as well. But let me know down below in the comments what your thoughts are when Fender go a bit off-piste. Personally, I think it's kick-ass, but it's not for everyone, is it? All the new colours of the Squier. Yes, there's Squier again. Squier are knocking out the park at the minute. Custom Esquires have landed. Sunburst, the beautiful blue with the cream binding setting off lovely, as well as the black at the end. That lovely kind of classic tuxedo look, but with only one pickup. And a three-way switch. If you want to find out more about that, Google PMTVUK Squier Custom Esquire. Now this is where I buy a lot of stuff. PMT have a huge selection of secondhand stuff. Obviously, Newcastle's a very, very small store, and this is all I've got right now, but some of this stuff doesn't even reach their website. So if you have something in mind that you want to buy secondhand, just give your local PMT store a call and we'll check out to see what secondhand stuff we've got. Like, I really want that Shawbucker. They're amazing pickups from Fender, and that's a secondhand one, so it'll be nice and cheap. Like a Duncan Hot Reel down there as well. Who's been part exchanging all these pickups? I mean, bravo, mate. You've made me want to modify some more guitars. Hello, Newcastle. I hope you're good. For the folk out there that don't know, we're based on Dean Street in Newcastle, just down from Gray Street, one of the most historic streets of all time. And we have 24 months interest-free finance on Taylor guitars. And look, there's Tim. Tim loves Taylor guitars. Let's dig to some Taylors. You haven't got a hide climb, it's fine. Some Kraken Taylors, what's that?
So what's this, you and me?
This is the beautiful Taylor AD-17E. It's the American Dream series.
I've never really heard of one of them before, is it?
Unbelievable, yeah. It's fairly new on the market. Lovely body shape. The black top is beautiful as well.
It's quite a quirky look, isn't it, with an Afro back with a black top and turn heads.
Of course, the Signature Expressions System 2 electronics in there. Oh, gorgeous.
Thank you.
Dagan hasn't mentioned as well, we are running 24 months interest free finance at the moment, so get on that. It's a wicked, wicked deal.
I'll tell you what, he knows his way around a corner too, does Ewan? Making that tailor sound beautiful, and you obviously can too. Now let's go find G-Mac to see what tasty stuff he has to show us.
G-Mac, my man, how's it going? That sounds good. What's this guy?
This is the Roland JU-06. It's a recreation of the classic Roland Juno, both the 60 and the 106 module on there, so you can swap between the two classic sounds.
Was it this big originally?
No, it was it was much bigger. It was much costlier as well. You'd have to have the equivalent of a modern day house deposit to afford one of these. Panel here, I have quite a lot in terms of control over the synth. So we have keyboard control on here, so we can hold the notes, which allows us to mess around and experiment with everything that's on the front panel here. We have chord mode as well, so we can play chords.
My favourite mode, so that actually makes me sound like I know what I'm doing when I'm just actually playing one note.
Absolutely, we have note mode on here as well. We have a sequencer built into it too.
So what are you changing there?
So I'm just changing the actual cutoff on here. So the filter. So it's got a full sequencer built inside of it. It's got an arpeggio as well, so we can arpeggiate all of the notes. We can obviously change the rate as well. We can change the range. So it's a really powerful kind of like performance tool.
Sorry, Jim, are you making this look easy, or is it just that easy to use?
It's pretty easy to use, to be honest.
The way you're explaining it, it sounds pretty easy, but
yeah,
it sounds from the speakers pretty rad.
It's actually really easy to use for anyone who likes, you know, like classic synth sounds, like synths used in synthwave, retrowave. I mean, it was even used on a lot of house and techno records.
Yeah.
It's a really simple and easy synth to get into. You've got all of your controls on here, so you can't really get lost with what you're doing, and it's ideal for experimenting. On top of that, you've got all the delicious patches that to go through as well, and you can manipulate and change those as you go.
Is it modular? Can you take this off?
It's modular in the sense that this, it just comes as the unit, and you buy this little keyboard separately.
Okay, so.
Yeah, so it slots into this little Roland keyboard, the K25, so you can make music on the go, and it has a little speaker built into the back of it as well. So
oh,
if
nice
you
one.
Do want to go and jam somewhere with it, you can plug your headphones, plug batteries into it, or you can listen to the speaker as well, so it's really handy for that. But just going through the panel, you've got your LFO. And then you've got your oscillator on here as well. You can add noise, you can add your sub onto this there as well, so you've got a sub oscillator which will give it a bit more beef here when I hit that on. So we'll turn it. You can hear the extra low end going
right,
which is great. You have a high pass filter on there as well for just filtering out any muddiness and nastiness. Obviously you've got your filter on here as well with envelope control, so attack, decay, sustain, release, all the typical that you'll find on there as well. And yes, you can switch between the two models, which have different characteristics. The other really cool thing is it's got the choruses built in as well, which give it a real bit of depth.
I know chorus from guitar stuff, guys.
You do,
I'm
mate.
Sure I am.
Exactly, so you'll know what chorus does. So we can hit it on and it gives it that classic kind of sound. If we change over to the 106.
That sounds
Honestly, it's proper beaut, man. And all the different patches that are on it as well are... You got lots of different banks as well. So yeah, you can do quite a lot with it.
That's kick-ass, G-man.
It's brilliant. And the other really cool thing about this is if you look on the back here, you have MIDI in and out for connection to any other equipment in your stereo. Nice you have one. A mix in so you can feed things into it, an output for your speakers, phones, and a USB. So you can power it from batteries or you can power it from this USB.
I was
going to
say, is this all just battery powered? So you can probably have this on the move, seeing as there's a speaker in the back as well.
Exactly. As long as you've got this little keyboard or something to play it with, essentially, you can do that. But the USB is really handy on this because not only will it power it, but you can actually send and receive audio and MIDI information from your workstation. So you could plug this in via USB and it would transmit audio and MIDI information inside of it as well. So it's really handy.
Wait, how are you doing that? What's that?
So it's note mode on here, so inside of this, if you push this and you don't have a keyboard, it gives you all your notes on the bottom.
Dissonant.
So yeah, you can use this to play a keyboard on it, basically.
Very nice.
And yeah, it's just class. It's one of my favourite little synths at this moment in time. Because I'm a big fan of the original Juno stuff and I own quite a lot of the plugins, but not any of the hardware.
To have it under your hands is a totally different ballgame though, like it's awesome.
Absolutely, yeah, it's class, man.
Nice one, cheers, G-Mac, this is Cass.
No problem.
Yeah, it's brilliant.
Check it out. Right, ladies and gents, it's Eddie Van Halen, Lick Lesson Time. Now, Eddie is one of my all-time guitar heroes. I love everything he's ever done, and I especially love this lick. I play it all the time and it sounds awesome. It blows minds from the front of the crowd all the way to the back. But it's easier than Eddie makes it look and makes it sound. It's from Spanish Fly, the song on Van Halen 2, his little follow-up to the first album's Eruption, and it's not played on the record on electric guitar, but midway through his live solos, he always throws it in, and this is what it sounds like. Tapping on, I'm going to teach you guys, there's a lot of notes in there, but if we slow it down, practice it slow, and then build up speed, you'll be top of the world in no time. Right, so this Kramer is an E-flat. You haven't got to be an E-flat, but it's just the way I like to tune my guitars. And it all starts on that good old G string. 5th fret. 5, 7, and you tap on the octave, the 12th fret. If you can get a good rhythm going with that, that's a good place to start. However, that's not the tapping riff. Start on the 5, 7, 12, and then descend, 12, 7, 5, but then pull off to the open string. So with 3 notes, it's pretty easy. Gets a bit harder when you start that doing that pull-off, but you'll get the swing of it and it sounds awesome when you absolutely nail it. And for the next part of the riff, you simply just go down a string to the D string and repeat the same notes with that pull-off. You don't want to do the pull-off to begin with, just do the regular 3-part tapping piece, okay? And
then when you finally get to the A string, which is the final of the three strings you're going to play in this little lick, just tap the 12th fret, and you're on the 7th fret, the same kind of beginning as the first two strings, but instead of going down to the 5th, you just chromatically go down from the 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and in between each slide down a fret, you tap the 12th fret. Do that as many times as you like. Eddie sometimes does it once, sometimes he does it 3 times. And that's essentially it. So, slowly. And you can either pull off to the open A string and maybe tap the 12th fret harmonic for a bit of fun, or what Eddie does, he taps the 12th, the 11th fret. It sounds like it doesn't fit, but you keep your finger on the 2nd fret of the A string and bend up to what will be the 12th, because when you have that 2nd fret, you can give it a bit of vibrato, because you can't really do vibrato with this finger. That makes sense. So 11th fret. So bend up using this hand, behind the string, behind the note even, to give it some vibrato, and it sounds kick-ass. Rock on, ladies and gents. Rock on and make Eddie proud. So there we have it, folks. This week's edition of PMT's Behind the Scenes Vlogs. I hope all the guys and gals out there have had a blast checking out some beautiful new Squier Affinity guitars, which you'll be seeing much more of very, very shortly. Had a little wander downstairs, watched Tim crack a safe. We checked out some fun colours on some Fenders, and obviously the 24 months interest-free finance on Taylor guitars that PMT are offering right now. PMT have had the UK's largest stock of Taylor guitars land, from the budget to the very, very expensive £8.5 million ones. Not that expensive, but still pretty expensive. So yeah, 2 years interest-free finance. It's the same as saving up for it, but you could actually have it, and instead of putting your money in a big Famous Grouse whiskey bottle, you just pay it off to the finance company. That's how I buy everything. It's the best thing in the world. We checked out some cool tech stuff with Gaz, and obviously we just learned one of the most iconic riffs from one of the most, like, well, from the most iconic player of all time. Comment down below what was your favourite bit or what you want to see in some vlogs coming up. If you guys want to learn some stuff, if you want some tone tips, let me know and we will try and deliver the best we can. All the products I've spoke about here today are linked in the description box down below. Besides this, this is my old Kramer 5150. If you want to make your own, get yourself one of the new Kramer 84s and just give it a couple of coats of paint yourself, just like Eddie did back in the day. I've had a lot of fun doing this video, and I will see you guys next week. Have a good one.